to the house. Amen. Hallelujah. We bless your name today, Father. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. I want to see you. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see.
Praise ye the Lord. And as we get ready to come before the Lord in prayer, and as we get ready to open up our service, we certainly do want to thank and praise the Lord for everyone coming on out home this morning, even during our Sunday school, being here, learning about Jesus. And we certainly want to praise God for our First Lady, Lady Tracy Quinn.
Yes. That's what I'm praying for.
October. Pray for the success of our service on today. And something you said again to encourage us and to inspire our hearts. And I pray that we will draw our minds in the Lord will send us a spirit of renewal, a spirit of revival. Amen. Thank you, Lord. We certainly praise God and give God thanks for all things. For it is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning us. We're here for a purpose. We're here for a reason. We're here to magnify the name of the Lord. This is the day that the Lord has made. Yes, Lord. We will rejoice and be glad in you. So we want to ask Minister Quinn if he would come up and lead us in prayer. Then we'll have Deacon Fields, as he's being studious right there. He will give us a scripture reading. Amen. That's pertinent for the hour.
Yes.
We'll do the song, pray. Let the church stand. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Yes, Lord, hallelujah. Let us all pray. Yes, Lord, Heavenly Father. We thank you, Lord God.
Yes, Lord.
We praise your holy name, Lord Jesus. We give you glory, Lord God. Oh, Father, in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you for waking us up this morning. We thank you, Lord God, for watching over our loved ones, watching over our children.
Yes,
we thank you, Lord God, for your provisions, Lord Father, and how you provide for us, Lord God. Oh, Father God, you are God of healing. You are God of power, Lord God. You are sufficient God, Lord God. Oh, Lord Jesus, in your holy name, Father, we give you glory, we give you honor, oh, Lord God. We give you honor, oh, Heavenly Father, for your mercy and grace, oh, Lord God.
Yes,
Father, we thank you, Lord God, for all the wonderful blessings that you have bestowed upon us, Lord God.
Yes, Lord.
We thank you for the blood of Jesus. Amen, yes, Lord God. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. We thank you for your love, your mercy, your grace. We thank you for your power. Lord.
chapter 9. We're going to begin with verse 7. There's our read.
Go thy way,
eat thy bread
with joy.
I don't hear everybody.
Everybody got a couple seconds. Anybody got it?
Okay.
All right. Let us read. Go thy way, eat thy bread with joy, and drink thy wine with a merry heart. For God now accepteth thy works. Let thy garment be always white, and let thy head lack no ornament. Live joyfully with the wife whom thou loveth all the days of the life of thy vanity, which he has given thee under the sun, all the days of thy vanity. For that is thy portion in this life, and in thy labor which thou takest under the sun. Whatsoever thy hand findeth to do, do it with thy might, for there is no work, no device, nor knowledge, nor wisdom in the grave whither thou goest. In this last verse, I returned and saw under the sun that the race is not to the swift, nor the battle to the strong, neither yet bread to the wise, nor yet riches to men of understanding, nor yet favor to men of skill, but time and chance happeneth to them all. And Lord, that's the word.
Amen.
Hold my hand, nothing but the blood of Jesus. Jesus.
I'm
Our purpose in this ministry and everybody that's connected to it is for you to promote the gospel of Jesus Christ. Amen? You promote this gospel of Jesus Christ through effective ministry and with intentional, creative, dynamic fellowship. And we thank God because we display our core values, our value love, we value commitment, patience, and sacrifice and service, and we value one another. If we put these core purposes and core values to heart, God will move in our atmosphere. God will help us. God will strengthen us. How many of you believe that today? Hallelujah. Not just that our people perish for a lack of knowledge, a lack of wisdom. Amen. It's good to follow after the purpose and the vision of the leading of the Lord. And as we put our minds together, we certainly thank God for how He has moved and how He is treating us and how He is keeping us. Thank you, Lord, my God. I thank God that we can have a place to catch on fire and burn with the Holy Ghost. We thank God for a saving station where people can get saved, where people can get delivered, where people can get help. Amen. Where yokes can be destroyed. How many know your atmosphere changes? Your opponent carriers. Hallelujah, my God. Hallelujah. Your glory carriers. Your atmosphere changes. Thank you, Lord. And your words and your praise can change an atmosphere. Your words and your praise can change a situation. Thank you, Lord. Don't let the devil fool you. Don't let the enemy trick you. Hallelujah, Lord. You're valuable in the kingdom of God. Yeah. In the kingdom of God. You're valuable in the kingdom of God. So we praise God for our value because the Bible says He put treasures in earthen vessels. I'm glad you put a treasure in me. Are you glad you put a treasure in you? Are you glad for your hope that lies beyond the grave? Are you glad for the Holy Ghost? I just need somebody to tell me they're glad for the Holy Ghost. Oh, hallelujah, can have that feeling. Hallelujah for the Lord on our side. Thank you, Lord. I'm glad for the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. I'm glad for the hope that I have down on the inside. Are you glad for the hope that you have down on the inside? That Christ in you is the hope of glory. Hallelujah. It's the hope of glory. Thank you, Jesus. So as far as our announcements are going on today, we thank God for the opening of our daycare center, New Horizons Daycare Center, on July 5th. Hallelujah, our hours of operation will be 6 a.m. to 6 p.m. We're serving 2.5 to 12 years old in age. Amen. And I want to say that we're open for registration. And we're open for job applications. We need supervisors, assistant supervisors, and aides. Thank you, Lord. And if you want to fill out an application or you want to register, please call 814-790-8561. Once again, that number is 814-790-8561. And if you know anybody that wants to apply, thank you, Lord, and you feel that they would be a good candidate, please spread the word. But if you've got some questions in your mind about them, you know, pray on them. Thank you, Lord. But we're open to all children of those ages 2.5 to 12 years old. And we have put together a curriculum for those children. I'm big on education. Thank you, Lord. We're going to work with them children. Send your children to us. My God, we're going to help them. My God, we're going to help them. I said, we're going to help them. Amen. Hallelujah. We're going to help them children. Thank you, Jesus. And give them potential where every day is a new learning and growing experience. And we certainly thank God that we're also going to have a staff meeting. All those that are here in the congregation with me that are staff members. We're going to have a staff meeting June 1st at 5 o'clock. That's this coming Tuesday at 5 o'clock. And you know, my meetings don't really last but an hour. I want my meetings to last an hour. So you come in on time, we leave at 6 o'clock. And you're going to get the job done. Amen? Sharing of information. So let us pray. Let us give God a praise for our daycare center. Amen. Let us pray for its great success, that God will continue to move on our behalf. It's a ministry. God has been dealing with my heart. He said, now what I'm giving you is part of a ministry. Amen. To ministry to affect the young people. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. It's a ministry. To affect the young people, to give people hope. Amen. Jesus said, suffer the little children to come unto me. And it'll be a safe haven for young people and children, so that they can build themselves up, so that they can get some skills, so that they can affect a generation. So I want to be a part of that. Amen. I want to be a part of what God is a part of. Amen. Hallelujah. I want to be a part of God's inheritance. I want to help God's inheritance. So as we move forward in this particular venue of ministry, we want you to be a part of it as well. If you're not a part of the staff, you can be a part of the prayer team. You can be a part of the prayer people that are spreading the word, getting the word out. Amen? Thank you, Lord. And tell somebody about what God is doing here at Christian Ministries at the Apostolic Faith Church. All right, and another part of our announcements, we're coming up this Saturday on a bowling extravaganza, which will be at Green Garden from 1 to 3 p.m. That's June 5th, which is this coming Saturday, from 1 to 3 p.m. All expenses for that particular bowling outing is paid by the Nightingale States Council, New York, New England, Pennsylvania States Council. So we want you to come out and come and be a part of this great event. New York, Pennsylvania, New England States Council. So Deacon Fields is in charge. He's large and in charge. Amen. Thank you, Lord. So see him. I'm going to give him the keys to drive the van as necessary, so to get the youth and get some adults out there bowling. Amen. Having some fun. It's good to have fun, amen. It's good to fellowship with the saints, amen. Hallelujah. Get to know one another. Thank you, Lord, in a different way. So we want you to come out and be a part of that. Also, too, June is coming up, June 13th. There's another revival unity meeting in Youngstown, Ohio. It's at 4 p.m., and I will be the speaker for that particular event. So those, we had a crew that went up last month. What was this month, really? We had a good time, didn't we? Amen. Good fellowship. Thank you, Lord. The brother was there and had a word, a good word from the Lord. And you know what I like about traveling with the saints, they let their hair down, so to speak, and we just laugh and talk about Jesus and talk about some good stuff, talk about our children. There you go. Just have a good time. Amen. Good laughing moments. So as we prepare ourselves, amen, to go, let us get ourselves together and ride to Youngstown, Ohio with the pastor and show your support. Also in June, we have June Council, 19th States Council coming up, June 25th and 26th. So registration is open. Those of you that want to register, you can give your registration to $10 to Sister Yolanda, or you can register on the 19th States Council website. Amen. So we thank God for that. We thank God for each and every one of you. It's blessing time. It's blessing time. It's blessing time in the sanctuary. Thank you, Lord. It's blessing time in the sanctuary. So we want to ask Deacon Fields if you would come on forward at this time. How many of you know that the Lord loves a cheerful giver? The Lord loves a cheerful giver. And we certainly do want to give unto the Lord. We want to give unto the Lord. We want to bless the Lord. The Bible says, give your tithes and your offering, and then also give unto the Lord a free will offering. We want to ask the church to stand. Thank you, Jesus. Let me get myself together. How many are looking forward to barbecue on tomorrow? Just a few of them. How many are looking forward to hamburger on tomorrow? Hot dogs.
Hot dogs.
There you go. There you go. You got one hot dog. No. In the box. There you go. Y'all just trying to fool me. Thank you, Jesus. Gracious Father, get your offering in your hand. Gracious Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we certainly do thank you for this opportunity to give and to sow seed into the kingdom. Lord, we ask you, Lord, that you bless the giver, bless the sower, bless the receiver. Let it be used for your purposes and for your glory, for the building up of the kingdom of God. Lord, we give you thanks and we give you praise. Lord, we ask you a special prayer that each contractor that is working here in this ministry, in this church, all this church, we ask you, Lord, that you bless her with integrity and honor that, and skill to get the job done. And Lord, to do a good job as they work as unto the Lord. We pray a special blessing upon them. In Jesus' name, amen. Come on and bless the Lord with me.
Dedicated to God. dedicated to God. That's the process of sanctification. That's the doctrine of sanctification. And then there's the doctrine of glorification. Paul teaches and tells us that if we walk with God, then our ultimate aim will be that we will be glorified. And we will be glorified in the presence of God. That we will receive a new mind. That this earthly tabernacle is going to be destroyed. And that we will put on a new tabernacle. We'll put on a new body, and we'll put on a new praise before God. So the book of Romans, it teaches us these doctrines, and this is what Paul, he's coming to the end of Romans chapter number 8, when he preached and he said that there is therefore now no condemnation to them that are in Christ Jesus, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. For the Spirit of life, which is in Christ, has literally made us free from the law of sin and death. What the law could not do, in that it was weak through the flesh, God sent in his own Son in the likeness of sinful flesh. And for sin, he condemned sin in the flesh, crushing, so that the righteousness of God's law might be fulfilled in you and I. That the righteousness of God can be fulfilled in you and I. Because God has a plan for us. God has a plan. How many of you know that God has a plan for you? God has a plan for you. And God took great pain and great trials and tribulation and great care and wisdom and knowledge so that he can bring about the fruition of his plan in your life. And when you come to Jesus, the Bible says you're no longer the servants of sin, but you're the servants of God. And that's why God gives you the gift of the Holy Ghost, because he realizes that Christ in you is the hope of glory. When the Holy Ghost comes upon you, it gives you power. It gives you power to live right. It gives you power to walk right. It gives you access to God. And it leads you and guides you into all truth. He said, now are you the sons of God. It doesn't appear what you shall be, but now you are the sons of God. If that Spirit be in you that raised Christ from the dead, it shall also make alive or quicken your mortal body. God has made ways for you. God has made plans for you. God has put things in place. He's put doctrines in place so that it solidifies your salvation. Now, if we were to look at the book of Romans, y'all just bear with me just for a moment. But I got to tell you what you got, because a lot of people don't know what they got when they're trusting in the gospel of Jesus Christ. Because this gospel is the power of God unto salvation. It calls you into holiness. It would freeze you from sin. It is what gives you an inheritance among them that are sanctified. But this gospel, this book of Romans specifically, it's like a Magna Carta. It's like a constitution. It's like a freedom document. It's like an emancipation proclamation. It lets you know the freedom that you have in God. And it lets you know the power that you have with God. And it lets you know that you got a deliverance over the devil. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. That's why the scripture says that all things work together for good to them that love God, to them that are be called according to his purpose. You've been bought with a price. You are not your own. My God, that's why you should glorify God in your mortal body. And that's why, my God, when the enemy tries to come up against you, you should tell him that I don't belong to you, but I belong to God. With you, even before the foundation of the world, before Savior, God, that knows something about you. You ought to thank God that you got a Savior that knows something about you. You ought to thank God that you got a Savior that can be touched with the feelings of your infirmities. That you're never alone. How many of you know that you're never alone? How many of you know that you're never alone? You see, brothers and sisters, when we come to this knowledge of what God has done for us, then we can come boldly, the Bible says, to the throne of grace, that we might obtain mercy and find grace to help us in our time of need. You see, brothers and sisters, we've got conditions, we've got issues, we've got an adversary, his name is the devil, that is trying to kill, steal, and to destroy us, but God, in his infinite wisdom and knowledge and understanding, he made a way, for you to come boldly to him, come with confidence. Oh my God, I come with confidence with my God. I come with confidence knowing that if I ask him for help, I know he sent me a helper. And his name is Jesus. God sent Jesus to bless you. God sent Jesus to help you. God sent Jesus to deliver you. Oh, how many of you know that today? Oh, that you got a deliverer. Oh, that you got a helper. All you need to do is call on the name. The Bible said that the name of the Lord is a strong tower. And the righteous runneth in, and they are safe. I got to ask you a question. Do you use Jesus in your time of trouble? Do you come? Do you come boldly to God's throne of grace that you might obtain mercy and find help in your time of trouble? Oh God, do you cast all your cares upon him? Do you know that he's a burning bearer and a heavy old shower? Do you cast your burdens upon him?
Holy Ghost to make intercession with you.
questions, but he's asking a rhetorical question. A rhetorical question is a question that makes you want to think. It's a question designed to persuade you. You see, God, he wants you to be persuaded. He wants you to be persuaded. He don't want you to have any doubts. He don't want you to have any concern about his will, about his ability, and about his power. If you want to offend God, you doubt him. If you want to offend God, you murmur and complain. But if you want to please God, if you put your trust in Jesus, not just something, but everything, oh God, that's why he said, trust in the Lord and do good, and verily shall now dwell in the land. Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and that leads to your own understanding. But you just acknowledge your God.
Yeah.
that your working labor is not in vain. The price has been paid. The way has been made. God is for you.
This game I went to,
up in the crowd and he says, save some of those runs for next game. So I'm going to save some of these words for next preaching sermon. Yeah. Hallelujah. But God is for you.
Yeah.
How many of you know God is for you?
Yeah.
Yes, God is for you. God has laid the foundation and he's opened up the way. Let us pray, gracious Father, in the name of Jesus, as we stand here in this gate, as we stand here, Lord, believing and trusting in you, Lord, we ask that you blood wash us and cleanse us, that you purge us from all unrighteousness, from every word, thought, deed, and every secret thought, through the blood of Jesus. And Lord, we ask you to remove all doubt, remove all fear from our heart, that we might walk worthy of this vocation where we've been called. Lord, open up our understanding. Grant us the spirit of revelation so we can see what we got and value it and walk therein. Father, we thank you for every assignment, for every purpose that you've given each to each of our servants. Lord, we ask you, Lord, that you bless us, that we fulfill it, that we walk in it. In Jesus' name, amen and amen.
Amen.
One Lord, one faith, one baptism. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
All right, I want y'all to just be seated just for a quick second. I want you to take me off.